What's up, sports designers? Mike with Sports Templates back with you for another awesome Sports Templates tutorial, and this one is going to blow your mind. I'm going to show you how to use this new flying basketball jersey template to create this Oakland jersey, and I'm going to show you all the stuff you get with this package. Before I do, like always, head down below, hit the like and subscribe buttons. Look for a link in the description to this to the asset library used for this design so you can follow along. And don't forget to drop a comment. Let us know what you think. We want to hear from you, so please do that. So before we get started on this awesome design, let me show you everything you get with this template. So you've already seen this view, the front view with a round collar. That's the standard, if you will. That's what you're gonna get. You're also gonna get the option to change to a V-neck collar if you want to, or to a wishbone collar. So if you wanna do, you know, any of the type of collars that you might see on a basketball jersey, you have all those options built into this template. You're also gonna get a couple other views with this template. Actually, I'm gonna leave that wishbone on because that's the one we're gonna use for this design. You're also going to get the back view and back-to-back view. So if you want to do the front and back of a particular jersey, if you want to do two different colors, however you want to set it up, you've got the option. All three templates are coming with this package. So three templates, three collar options, all in 7K resolution, okay? And when you look closely, you can just see I'm hitting controller command and the plus key on the keyboard. You get the awesome realistic textures that you're used to getting with sports templates, right? You've even got a tag on here. We've got the collar texture. We've got the jersey texture. We've got the texture for the letters and numbers overlaid onto the jersey. All the realistic lighting and stitching, shadows everywhere, professional background with customizable text. You can customize all the colors. So all the awesome stuff you're used to getting with a sports templates product. Three templates in one, three different views, three different collars, just awesome stuff. Just in time for basketball season. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started on the design. I'll just show you one more time what we're gonna be working on. It's this Oakland jersey, just a kind of an old school looking design that I threw together for this tutorial. So I wanna show you how we achieve that. So let's go ahead and start with our background. I'm gonna go into the background folder. I'm just gonna pick my background color and I have it saved here in the library for you. I want to show you kind of how I got to that. So I just started with the gold color that's in the palette. And, you know, that's really, really bright and bold. So I kind of wanted to just create something that was going to be easy on the eyes and give you some contrast with the dark blue that I'm going to use for the jersey. So if you go into that color, if you can choose any color from your palette, you can just go in and you can just bring the saturation down. I'm going to bring it down to like 25%. And kind of see where we come out. And I like that. That's really, really close, right, to what we started with. You can also play with the brightness, right? So if you want to bring the brightness down, maybe bring that down to, we'll say 75%. And that gets a little too brown for me. So brightness is going to move you up and down here, and saturation is going to move you left and right. So I'm just going to drag and kind of get somewhere into this area. And I think that's pretty close, right, to what we had here in the palette. Pretty close. Palette color is just a little bit lighter. So that's how I arrived at that color if you just wanted to know. Let's go ahead and change our text background. I'm going to double click on this layer and we'll just double click on the top line and we'll just type Oakland. And how about rather than jersey, we make the bottom say basketball. And it's okay that we're spilling over the edges here. That's just kind of a design thing. You know, it looks kind of cool. We know what the words say without seeing all of the word. So I'll go ahead and minimize the background folder. Let's get into our editable parts. So this is where we go to sort of change everything about the jersey, all the different parts of the jersey. We've got our effects folder in here. So this is what gives it the realistic look. If you turn that off, you've got just kind of a flat 2D situation. You've still got 3D going on your letters and numbers and on your collar because those effects are separate, but just to give you an idea. So that's where the effects are. Let's kind of work our way up from the bottom. So back panel color, we'll make that blue. And these smart objects here, which you're usually gonna see color coded in purple for smart objects, these control the side panels. So let's do some side panel designs. Let's go in here. We'll make it yellow or gold. And then I'm gonna go ahead and add some pinstripes to this. And how I did that There's a couple different ways you can do this, but I've gotten pretty good at doing it pretty quickly a certain way. So I'm gonna hit Controller Command J to duplicate my background layer because it is a shape layer. So it's just easy to create it instead of going over here and finding my shape tool and doing all that. So I'm gonna create it, I'm gonna change it to blue. I'm gonna hold down the shift key and I'm just gonna bring that down really, really thin. If I remember right, I wanna go somewhere around 18 pixels and I'm gonna zoom in a little bit to help me get there. So controller command plus, and let's go back. I'm just gonna hold shift and then we get down to about 18 pixels. Now there's a couple ways you can do this. There's a way that sometimes works and sometimes doesn't for me, depending on how Photoshop is behaving. And that is to hit controller command J to copy your shape and then just kind of drag it over to where you want it. So I want to get it, you know, around there. And then if you hit control shift alt and T, it's working. It will repeat that shape across for you. And I'm just going to press it a bunch of times. I'm sure I'm off the canvas by now, but I'm gonna hit control zero to back out. And yeah, I made way too many. Now, one of the drawbacks to that is that it puts it all in one shape. So if you wanted to move some of the shapes, it's a little more difficult. If you wanted to change the colors of some of them, it's a little more difficult. But sometimes that doesn't work if Photoshop's being a little bit buggy, and so I'll just, you know, manually drag and copy each shape. But it did work, so that was cool. So I'm gonna hit controller command zero, and I know already this is gonna be too many stripes, or it's just a little too thick. Right, I'm hitting controller command plus to zoom in, and let's scroll over here. And what we can see is it's just too dense, right? I kind of want to spread those out a little bit. So I'm gonna zoom in here again, controller command plus. I'm gonna grab my direct selection tool, and I'm just gonna choose, if it wants to let me. Photoshop doesn't want to let me. Let's try this one. Path selection tool. There we go. Choose every other one and just delete. All right, and then I might even adjust this just a little. I'm gonna click and drag and hold down shift just to get a whole stripe in there on that edge. Now let's hit control or command S and go out here and see, and that's better for me. I like the amount of stripes and the size and the distance that I have between them. So now I want to do the same thing on the other side. So I'm just going to open that smart object up. Again, I'm going to set my background color to my gold, and I'm going to go back to my previous one, and I'm just going to select that layer, and I'm not worried about all this extra for now. If you wanted to save file size, sure, but I'm not worried about that right now. I'm going to right click on it, and I'm going to duplicate layer, and I'm going to move it into my other side design smart object, and it's going to be in the, you know, pretty much the same position. I'll just drag it over. And this one's a little different because I forgot I started on the other one with the already having a stripe in place. So I just need to get rid of one of these. And again, Photoshop loves to be difficult. I'll just drag this over a little bit more. I guess that's good right there. Controller command S to save it. And there we go. We've got stripes on our side panels. I'm gonna hit control zero to recenter that. And then let's move on to the next part of our design. Nothing on the back. So the back design is where you would put, if you wanted to put something that was gonna show up here, and this is the one you would use if you were doing the round collar. But because we're doing the wishbone collar, we're gonna go into the wishbone folder and we'll find the back design up there. And for this, I don't necessarily want any sort of a design per se, but I do want to put in the label. So I'm going to drop in this label and I'm just going to kind of size it to where I think it needs to be, maybe like that. And I don't want it to be this, it's kind of a purple color, the one I saved in the library. I want to I've got some keyboard shortcuts here, so I'm going to rasterize this layer. I don't really need to, but I'm going to rasterize this layer using my keyboard shortcut of Control R, or you could just right click on it and rasterize layer. And then I'm going to do a color overlay. I have a keyboard shortcut for that, which is Control O. Your keyboard shortcut is not going to match that, but you can change your keyboard settings and create different shortcuts if you want to. Or you could just go down here, go to FX, color overlay, and add it that way. So I've added that label and I've made it white, and let me close these other smart objects. Let's just go and see. I really like that placement. I think I'm going to zoom in, controller command plus, then I'm going to hold the space bar so I can drag. And I think I'll move it to a little to the right because I want this line to line up with this tag. So I'm just going to grab it and just move it a little to the right. I'm holding the shift key when I do that so it doesn't move up or down. I just want it to move left or right. And that's good. I'm happy with that. So I'm going to keep that there. I'm going to hit Control 0 to zoom back out to the kind of the full view. And then let's get into finish the rest of our collar. So we do have smart objects here if you want to change the designs, do some stripes or different patterns on the collar. For this one, I just did use a solid color. So I'm just going to set that to the gold. And then I'm all done with the collar. So I'm going to go ahead and get out of there. And while I'm here, I might as well do this label. So if you go into this label folder here, you'll find a color for it. I'm going to set that to gold. And you'll find a smart object for the label design. And let's just go in there. I'm going to set my background here to gold so I can see what I'm working with. And we'll just drop this logo on it. And I'm going to shrink that down a little bit. Can't see it because it's gold on gold, but I'm going to fix that in a moment. I'm going to go ahead and set my foreground color here to blue by clicking on this blue. And then I'm going to, instead of using my keyboard shortcut, I'll do it this way. Choose a color overlay. I'm going to choose this color. And I'm going to hit Controller Command S to save it. And now you can see we've got it there, and let's zoom in so you can see. Again, I'm hitting Controller Command Plus on my keyboard. You just scroll up there. There you go, we have a nice tag. Look at the detail there. Very realistic looking tag, shadow and everything. So we can close those smart objects that we had open. Again, I'm gonna hit Controller Command Zero to go back out to the full view. And then let's work on the rest of the jersey. So back into our editable parts. We've got smart objects here to do different collar designs, but again, because we're using this wishbone collar that's over the top of that, we don't need to worry about those. Let's go to the right cuffs. So if you wanted to do a design there, you could do that. And you can even do it on the inner part. But again, I just use a solid color here. So I'm gonna turn all those off and I'm just gonna set that color again to my gold. And then we have a smart object for the front design. So I'm going to set the jersey color itself to the blue, and then if I turn off that front design, you can see we've got the nice blue jersey. But I do want to use this front design smart object. This would be if you wanted to do like a sublimated design on the fabric itself underneath kind of the letters and the numbers that are attached to the top. And I do have some piping that I want to add to this. So again, I'm going to go in here. I'm going to change my background color to blue because that's the color of my jersey. And if you look in this asset library, I've got some preset stripes to kind of act as piping on the side of the jersey. So I'm just going to position that there and there. And I'm going to hit Control or Command S to save and just go out and see. And that's exactly where I want them, just to kind of line up with the shape of the jersey. So that's perfect. So I'm going to close that smart object. And now the only thing left to do is to change our name and number. We've got a sample on here, right? So if we go into the embossed logo and graphics folder, we can scroll down and we see this smart object to add your design. And there's another one underneath it. It's actually a copy. And this is what gives it the depth. So if you zoom in, you can see there's some shadows and things underneath that make this look more realistic, more 3D. If we turn that off, you can see how it kind of loses that. So just to give you an idea of what that is, right? So if you go into the Add Your Design Here folder, again, I'm gonna set my background to blue just because I like to see what I'm working with. But when I save this, I don't wanna keep the background on. because that'll put a whole layer of blue, like 3D, you know, letter and number material, like a tackle twill. It'll put a whole layer of that over the top of my jersey, and I don't want that, right? I want the jersey to be the regular jersey fabric, and I want this to be a different fabric for the name and number. But I'm going to turn it blue now just so I can see better, right? If I keep it transparent, or if I set it to another color, it's a little bit harder to see. So I'm going to set it to blue. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to leave this name and number on. These are text layers, so you can edit the text with these if you want to, right? You can put whatever name you want to here, and it'll pre-bend. I didn't type that very well, but it'll pre-shape it if that's the kind of style that you want. But I'm going to leave those turned on just so I have kind of an idea of where I want to put this. And I'm going to drag this design that I made before out here, and it actually ends up lining up perfectly with it anyway. So I'm going to turn those off. I'm going to turn off my background color now, because remember, I want the yellow to sort of pop off of the blue. And if I save this with the blue on here, it's all going to appear to be on the same level of depth, and I don't want that. So I'm going to turn the blue off, hit Control or Command S to save, and come out here and hit Control or Command 0 to zoom all the way out. And there we have it. Actually, it looks a little high to me, so let's just move it down just a little bit. Just drag it down. Controller Command S again, and that's better. So I'm happy with that placement. So you can see how easy it is to create a really realistic looking jersey with this template. And so let's take a look at all the cool details in here. Again, zooming in, you can see this is the texture I was talking about. It's different on the letters and numbers, right? It's like a tackle twill, looks really realistic. Then you've got the jersey texture underneath, and you can see all the lighting and the shadows in there. It's just super, super realistic looking as we move around. I'm just holding the space bar so that my cursor turns into that little hand and just dragging around so you can see all the awesome details. Again, the shadows and everything else that you get to see. And I want to show you one other thing that you typically get with these templates, and that is the dynamic lighting. So the dynamic lighting allows you to change the lighting on the jersey if you wanted it to look different than it does now, maybe just to fit a different scene, right, that you're trying to put together, or just get a completely different look. You can do that using the dynamic lighting that's built into these templates. It's a smart object, and if you turn it on, you're going to notice it's right now it just happens to be set to a pretty extreme lighting. But if you double click, let me close this other one. If you double click to go into the smart object, you can edit all of this lighting just by using the properties here. So you can drag this slider left or right to get basically 360. It's a loop. If you go from all the way left to right, it just resets itself. So you can change the light if you wanted to go super washed out for some reason. Maybe you just wanted to bring light in from, you know, a certain direction. You can play with the saturation. So if you don't want it to be so extreme, you can do that too. You can play with the lightness, right? So it's very, very customizable. So let's just say we wanted to just, you know, put kind of a lot of light kind of on these folds, right? We're just putting a lot of light on those. We'll do that. We'll hit Control or Command S. And you can see now there's more light there if we turn it off, right? So very, very cool, very dynamic, which is why it's called dynamic lighting. So there's a lot of really cool things you can do. And again, really fast, really, really easy setup in a way that's really easy for you to use, navigate, find everything. So really hope you go and pick this one up over at sportstemplates.net. Hope you enjoyed today's tutorial. Go pick up the new template. Remember, you're going to get all three views, three collar styles. You got the back-to-back in there. So anything you want to do, you can really pull off with this template. One more time, don't forget to go down below, hit the like and subscribe buttons, and leave us a comment. As always, thank you guys so much for watching, and enjoy this.